Hi there. Today I have the chance to talk to Anders a little bit about the orbital welding system ABIBUG 300, made in Germany and made for pipe welding. Anders, with the ABIBUG 300, can I weld any pipe or are there limitations?
No, you can weld any pipe over the size of 10 inches, which is about 300 millimeters.
Okay, so and I could even have like big ones and small ones, and I just need the right band and then I can go with it.
Exactly. The bug works with any band from 10 inches up to more or less flat, okay, without any additional parts being added to it.
Okay, so what is the main advantage if you take a semi-automated orbital welding bug like ours compared to manual welding? That's done by stick, I think.
There are several advantages compared to manual welding. First of all, you do not stop welding, so you have a consistent weld from 6 o'clock to 12 o'clock. The welder or the operator stands next to the machine and controls it via a remote control, as we have here, instead of welding. So his work environment is much improved.
And you told me that, I didn't know that, that while you do your stick welding, you have to stop and to change the electrode.
Yes.
So you have a lot of time that is consumed by that.
Yes, and also every time you stop, there's a risk of welding defects. Every time you stop and restart, there's a welding risk of welding.
So I'm faster and have less risk of defects, less risk of repair. So it improves the productivity.
Yes.
Okay.
And it's also, as I said, it ergonomically improves this work situation of the.
Yeah, it's the strain of the welder is less. Yeah. Okay. And but you told me that one thing you have, it's important that the groove is prepared in a good way. Can you say something?
Yeah. With all mechanized welding, semi-mechanized welding, you need to have a proper preparation of the groove. Otherwise, because you cannot in the same way compensate for misalignment that you can for a manual welder. That goes for all, let's say, automatic welding.
Okay, and if I compare the semi-automated welding of a pipe with a bug like that with automated welding, I mean, that's existing as well. So what's the difference here?
No, this is a lot less complicated. Oh. It is a lot less complicated to set up and it's cheaper. Mm-hmm. It needs a lot less extra equipment.
Okay.
And it is a lot less complicated to work with.
Okay, talking about the features of the ABIBUG, so it's easy in handling, I would say.
Yes, definitely. So that is the key reason why it was developed, was that it was to be easy to handle and ergonomical to manage.
Yeah, it has like, what's the weight of it?
With a full 5 kilogram spool on, it's still below 20 kilos, around 18 to 19.
So I can carry it easy, and I understand that it has a certain position for the service as well.
Yes, you can put it on the side, supported by the wire feeder. So you can put it on a flat surface to do maintenance on the undercarriage.
Okay. Yeah, talking about, okay, that's easy handling, so easy to operate. You already mentioned the remote control. So what is the most important functions that you will do with the remote control?
The most important part, the function of the remote control is to follow the groove. So if there are any changes or misalignment, you can move, you can change the center line, and you can also widen the oscillation of the remote control here with these buttons. The welder controls the unit, so he can here control the travel speed, he can control the oscillation of the welding head, he can control the angle of the torch, and he can also move the center line of the weld if needed.
And I understood that, Iman, if I need to do something with the torch, that's easy as well, so changing consumables and stuff like that.
Yes, it is prepared so you can just sort of easily set it in a maintenance position and then change all the items here, all the gas nozzles and the contact tips that need to be changed.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and that the torch that comes with the ABIBUG 300, that's a machine torch. It's an ABIMIG 305 pipe. Can you say something around that? This is specially made for this system.
Yes, it is. On most other similar bugs on the market, there are several. The cable, there are three or four cables coming here, with one with a wire, which makes it more complicated to change. So this is only one bicox, and it's easy to change in one go.
Yeah, and it has a certain torch neck. I think it's short, so that you have a good position to the pipe.
Yes.
Okay. So now talking about, this is made to survive the conditions by pipe welding. So it has a lot of features that is around, let's say, protection and robustness. Can you tell something to us about that?
Yeah, the cover here is specially designed to, all the sensitive parts are covered here. And it is, so they're protected under this cover here, which is also spatter repellent. So it is much better protected in different parts than for the most other units on the market.
And it has this railing around, so this protects it a little bit as well. And
yes, but it also makes it much easier to carry handle.
Yeah. Okay, and I understood that there's like buttons that you press and then you can move the bug around.
Yes, so you have four buttons, two on each side, that you can press so you can move the bug manually on the band, getting it down from to the starting position again after the.
And the bug, it comes in a transportation case that is protected against dirt and dust and everything. So. That is something you can put even on the construction place in a project onshore welding, pipe welding.
Yes, it is airtight, an airtight box, and you can ship it by air, you can ship it by and it's or leave it out in the rain, and it's completely safe.
Coming back to easy handling, I mean, if I need to change the spool, that is even patented, I think, this locking thing.
Yes. So changing your spool, we have a patented system here with patented spool holder, which makes it, you just remove the cover, and then you have a locking device, and you just take out the spool and change it.
Mm-hmm. And setting the bug on the band, that's a special mechanism, I think, that is easy as well.
Yes, there is one lever on one side here that you press, and then you just put it on the band and you release the lever and it sits there.
Mm-hmm. And the ABIBUG 300, if I take it for different pipes, for different applications, there's only a little thing that I need to change, but I don't have to change like rolls or something like that.
No, you don't need to change any parts on the way. If you go from a small diameter to a much larger diameter, you just need to change the location of the screws here. Mm-hmm. So you don't need to mount any new parts on it, which you have to do on many of the other bugs in the market.
Okay, I understand. Okay, the system is the torch, the bug, then I need the band for the pipe, and then I need some more equipment to make it run.
Yeah, yes, obviously you need a power source, the welding power source.
Okay.
And it, ABIBUG works in most standard power sources on the market.
Okay, so thanks Anders for all these informations about the ABIBUG 300, the features, and its German technology is protected against a lot of things that are around when you have a project for pipe welding. So yeah, if you need more information, please check out our website. There's a lot of further information about the ABIBUG 300 and the torch and everything. Thanks for watching. See you next time.